John here. I've had several requests for a video showing how to clean a revolver, and I'm going to show you all today how I like to clean my single six. First thing I like to do, of course, is check and make sure it's not loaded. Then I'll remove the cylinder. To do is take a little hops and I like to go ahead and just kind of scrub the end of the barrel there, but I'm careful not to let the hops get down into the action of the revolver. And I just work it in there a little bit. Nothing major. And I like to scrub the end, the chamber end, and also the both ends of the cylinder. I don't know what this end is called. So if somebody knows, you can let me know. Then what I'll do is I'll wet a patch. Run a patch up my bore. Good and wet, and then run a patch down each one of the chambers. Now I like to let this soak either 10 or 15 minutes maybe, or as much as overnight. Just depends on what I'm doing. Now I've let the single six soak for probably 24 hours now, so I'm going to go ahead and finish it up. I generally will let it soak for overnight, or I don't know, a day or two. Just depends on what kind of notion I get in. Let's see if I can find my toothbrush. So after I've let it soak, I'll go ahead and scrub on it a little bit. Now I like to sharpen the tip of my toothbrush into a point. That way I can kind of get in there and scratch at any kind of carbon. Although that's not necessary. It's just personal choice. And if need be, you can take a little brass pin or something and scrape some carbon, but it all depends on what your purpose for cleaning is. My purpose is to restore accuracy. I don't ever clean every time I shoot. I normally clean maybe every two or three times, maybe as much as every dozen times. It just depends on how much I shoot and what I'm doing. Of course, I shoot my 22 a lot, so I maybe clean it once every month or two. As soon as accuracy starts dropping off, or the chambers get hard to slide the bullets in, or if the chambers get a lot of soot and I guess it's powder residue build up here or right in there. When it starts looking bad, I'll go ahead and scrub on a little bit. Let's see. Probably be better if I had a bore snake or something that would go from the breech end instead of the muzzle end, but oh well, I deal with it. I generally try to be pretty careful. after I've let it soak, and then after I've went back over it with wet patches, just like I did the first time, what I like to do, so I'll take me a patch, and I'll run it down the board dry. Of course, this ain't news to most people, but maybe somebody out there doesn't know what to do. So I'm gonna show you. And pull it back. Just gotta take a look at it. And that don't look too bad. So I'll do one wet one and one dry one, alternately, until the dry one comes out with just cleaning solvent on it instead of any fouling. And if it gets if it's really fouled, what I'll do is I'll go ahead and, before I start patching it, or even after I've started, but if I think it needs it, I'll go ahead and use a brass bristle brush and scrub the bore a little bit. But generally, I do like this, and take a look at it, and then I like to take a flashlight. I have to go get one. You have to hold on. Unprepared, but I'm back. So take a flashlight and shine up. I can look up in there and see if there's any kind of fouling. Which fouling will look like, it'd be like a dark gray spot or a maybe like a little lump. But generally, if you keep your barrel clean, and especially if you shoot jacketed ammo, you don't have a lot of fouling. I mean, you can get copper or brass fouling, but with 22s, it's not as common as with high-powered rifles. Let's see. My patch material is cut from old t-shirts. I think that's pretty good. That's generally all I do. Let's see. Like I said to start with, I want to make sure I don't get any solvent running down in the holes of the action, like the firing pin hole, the, let's see if I can get you a good view, firing pin hole, opening for the hand, down where the gate is, or down where the cylinder pin goes. Although I will clean on that, but I try to do it with a brush that doesn't have a lot of solvent on it. Scrub it if need be, or I'll make sure I use oil. You want to make sure you don't get a lot of oil down in your firing pin hole. Won't hurt it for a 22, but if it's a center fire, then the oil can run out of that hole onto your primers, get down into your cartridge, and cause misfire. It's not real common, but it does happen. I generally don't spray oil onto the action like that. I'll try to spray the rag and wipe it. It just depends though. Depends on how clean you want it too. I guess I could probably clean on it all night until every speck of dirt is gone, but it's just gonna get dirty again. A lot of this ain't gonna help it shoot any better, so. What you mainly wanna worry about is if you got any kind of buildup right here, right there on the end of your barrel, or if you have any buildup right here around your chambers, the end of your chambers, and if you got any buildup around the other end of your chambers, it impede the cartridges setting like they should. So if it's setting on a little piece of dirt and you go to shoot it, it might crush that piece of dirt and cause a misfire. It's a pretty soft brass rod I'm using, so I ain't too worried about scratching it. Go ahead and finish up with a an oily patch. So I'll spray one patch with oil on that end. Trade that for a dry patch. And then I'll, after I do that, I'll leave it alone. For lubrication, I like to use 3-in-1 oil or something similar. And I'll put one drop where the hand goes. And I'll put one drop on the cylinder stop. And I'll put one drop there for the gate. And I'll wipe off any excess that I can get to. And then down in the hammer, let's see if I can get the light on it and show you. Let's see. Right there, right at the bottom of your hammer, you can see there's a little, looks like a silver plunger. And it is a plunger. What I like to do is try to get one drop right in there on that. And that'll work its way around. But that plunger goes in and out. And I had the plunger bind up in the hammer one time. And it locked the gun up. It was bent, so I had to get another. So I'm always careful to go ahead and oil that. I just wipe any excess oil out. So, set that aside. Do something pretty darn similar to the cylinder. You can change your patch every time if you want for every chamber, or you can do three chambers. You can do all six, just depends on what you're doing or how dirty it is. That's not too bad right now. You just hold it up and look through it, through the light. I think I'm gonna scrub it with a board brush. Well, let's see, I'll use a different one. Oh yeah, that looks nice. I'm gonna let that go. I'll just look and make sure there's not any dirt here on the where the rim of the cartridges go. End of the chambers. And pick it out and scrub it if there is. Don't forget to do the cylinder pin hole. You don't really have to clean it unless it's dirty. All you have to do is wipe it out. Lubricate each one. Go back over it again with a dry patch. remove any kind of oil that's in there. I just like to finish it all. Wipe it good and clean. And then, sure, it's very simple. Make sure there's nothing wrong with your cylinder pan. Now on the Ruger, there's a little plunger in the end of your cylinder pan that pushes the transfer bar out. I just put a drop of oil on that. But I like to put grease on the cylinder pan. This is actually Tetra gun grease, but the tube got all messed up, so I just took it out of the tube and I just stick my finger down in there and get some when I want it. And now I'll give it some nice lubrication. Still tight, just the way I like it. And of course, anytime you clean one, you generally see something you want to clean after you get her put back together. So just your personal choice on what you clean and how you clean it. Some people clean the whole gun inside and out, but I don't. This is the way I do regular maintenance. So one thing I forgot to mention I like to do is, if it's dirty, I'll just check and look. Anytime I see dirt in the holes for the cylinder stop, I'll go ahead and clean those out. But I do that pretty regular. I just, anytime I do anything to the gun like this, I just kind of generally look. And anytime I see dirt or dust maybe on the sights, anything other than oil and bluing, I scrub it with a toothbrush if it needs it. And generally, I don't like to use the same rag for cleaning as for oil or for wipe down. You want to have a clean rag for wipe down, one that ain't got like a bunch of crud on it, because that crud will scratch your bluing. But the bluing's almost gone on this anyway, but oh well. That's the way I'll do it. General cleaning maintenance for prolonged plinking. This is John. God bless y'all. Signing off.